Hello, you doubters of Michelle Rodriguez's divinity. Jim Sterling here, and this is ABZÛ. I woke up this morning and I saw Twitter and immediately thought, what the fuck is ABZÛ? Because everyone on Twitter was talking about ABZÛ. And then I went on Steam and I typed in ABZÛ, A-B-Z-U, on Steam, and saw it immediately and thought, ooh! So here it is. Gonna play it. New game. There we go. This is a game made by the, I'll say, the creative director of Flowers and Journey. I think it's just Flower. Not remembering games correctly, but either way, someone from those games was involved with this one. So I'm expecting good things. I like Flower. I love Journey. Journey is one of my favourite games of maybe all time. Certainly one of the best interactive experiences I've ever played, you know? So I've been looking forward to this all day. When I first looked it up on Steam, it was due to unlock in 4 hours. Then I got sidetracked. I did a little AMA thing on the Jim Sterling subreddit. Just as a replacement for Ask FM, while we're working on integrating a new Ask system into the Jimquisition website. And that took up a lot of time, and there's like 600 questions on there, and I think I got through 50. Between 50 and 100 before I was like, I'm really tired and have to stop for a bit, and the questions ain't stopped. So that'll be just something I drop into now and then. What did I press to dive? I don't even know. Anyway, it's nice. Hold to swim. I can do that. There we are. Kicking our little flippers around. So, clearly this is being made on... I say clearly. I certainly assume this is being made on a smaller budget than Flower and Journey. The environments, character models, they look a lot more simplified, which is fine. If this is indeed a smaller scale game, I don't expect them to match Journey and Flower, both of which were incredibly beautiful games. And if you ever played them on PS4 especially, they really look gorgeous. Look at that big fish. Love a big fish. What? Oh, shut up. Shut up, I'm swimming on a Goliath grouper. Oh, yes. Okay. I'm on board with this. There we go. Fuck yeah. Okay, it's gone now. I didn't let go of it, it just went. I guess you can only ride a thing for so long. Let me go here. It's just kind of harassing the fish. I suppose that's not too cool. Can we ride it again? Oh, shut up. Shut right up. You're steering it around. I've got Goliath groupers coming out my arsehole here. Tons of them. Oh my God, they eat the fish. Oh, this is exciting. This is good. Right, shove Journey up your fucking ass. I'm being facetious there. I'm genuinely thrilled at this. This is so... so nice. Seahorse, don't eat the seahorse. I don't want to eat the seahorse. Let go of the grouper now. What's that tiny little thing? See the little tiny green fish there? Stay still for a minute. Let's have a little look around. Look at our person. Very cat-like look. Sort of feline-like eyes. And the helmet has ears. They look like cat ears anyway, was the point I was trying to make. Where have we got more seahorses? The microphone is right between my face and the screen. So I don't want to lean too forward and you know, get my plosives sounding too bad on the microphone. I already have trouble with that because I still haven't worked out a good optimal distance between the microphone and my mouth with this new mic I've got. But that is something. It's funny because it was only a few weeks ago I was up at Atlanta, Georgia, on a little mini weekend for the holiday weekend. Went up there to see some people. And I had a day free before I had plans in the evening that unfortunately I had a couple of different plans in the evening that didn't pan out quite how I intended, but I did have a nice day free. Okay, pressing to interact. What is it? Got a little shell. I don't know what the shell does. And anyway, the point is that I went to the aquarium they've got there. The Georgia Aquarium. I don't know what that does. What else can I do? Roly-poly! Thank you. Happy with that. So anyway, went Georgia Aquarium. So seeing things like the grouper and everything is somewhat exciting for me. Because I was seeing all that shit just a few weeks back. Really nice aquarium. Didn't see any squids or anything there, which upset me. Like, if I go to an aquarium, one of the first things I want to do is look at all the gross, weird, freaky shit. And they didn't have a lot of that. Had, a lot of pretty fish and back button to meditate. Okay. Male California sheephead. We're learning about fish. Only trouble is what is the California sheephead? Is it the yellow one? Is it the light red bordering on orange one? Or is it the black and red one? I don't know. Male California sheephead all over the place. Female California sheephead. Which one is highlighted? I'm trying to see which one it's focusing on. Maybe the orange ones? Anyway, so a lot of fish. Yellow tang. Okay, well, we definitely worked out what the yellow one is. So, yellow tang. The males must be the red and blacks, and the females must be the orange. And then we've got these little flat ones. Oh, it went whizzing right over. Well, that's fun. Let's get out of there now. What an incredibly pleasant game. Whee! I know these games have their critics, these styles of games. From Flower to Journey, some people don't like the sense of a lack of interaction. And in general, Hawksbill Sea Turtle, look at them go. Wow. A lot of people don't see the point of games like this. And I'm... with certain games, I agree. I once did a very, very old Jimquisition called The Weird Is Not Enough. Games that give you a lot of weird environments and characters, but very little interaction. It was a criticism I had of Nobi Nobi Boy as well, where all of these weird and wacky NPCs... Oh, look at that, like Echo the Dolphin. A lot of these weird and wacky NPCs... I'm going to do it again. Were dancing around, cavorting, doing all sorts of fun things. And it looked like they were having more fun in the world than you were. And that's my big problem, is when I'm seeing all these NPCs I can't really do much with. I don't mind a game with limited interaction. And I don't mind a game where there is no overall goal. You know. No combat, no puzzles or anything, you know, no real hindrances. Can I ride that? Don't look like it. So long as there's something to delight, something that compels me to keep exploring. And that's certainly what these guys have always excelled at with Flower and Journey. is they have just the right amount of visuals and music and a sense of scale, like things scaling. Look at these crabs. I love crabs. Crabs and lobsters, big fan of. Crustaceans in general. I do know there's that thing tinkling there, but I just want to look at the crabs some more. I'd love a... I don't think there is one, but I'd love a first-person view. Just pressed all the buttons there, couldn't really find one. So what's this business? We've fixed something. Little robot. The robot giving us a scan. Oh, look at that. And, you know, there's things to do. Okay, it's not exactly... shooting things or puzzle solving, but it's exploring and finding and uncovering stuff. And I feel done right with that growing sense of scale as the music gets more rousing and more things happen around you. That can work really well. That's the difference between this and a game like Wonder or... What was the other one? Was it called Submerged? I'm not entirely sure, but... We've played a few games that sell themselves on being non-combat, exploration-based, and it's normally a watchword for we didn't put anything worth doing in our fucking stupid game. And then you get the rare gem where it's like, no, there's stuff. And the world we made is just so enthralling that it's worth exploring for its own sake. And very few games that try this stuff really get that. I hope that makes sense. You know, normally when I talk about more... Game design is by my own admission, it's not my forte. I do approach it from... You know, my style of game criticism is very immediate. I'm not a deep game critic, I fully admit that. Lobster! Lobster! No, come back. There we are, talking about my depth as a critic and then stopping to shout, Lobster! That's me. That's me, chuffing idiot. Right. I realise I'm just going round and round in circles. Let's press forward a little bit. See what this red netting is over here. Got a little robot as well here to deal with. See another lobster there. Fuck, I love lobsters. So cool. Anyway, as I was saying, you know, I fully... confess that my style of criticism is very immediate, often more, you know, customer focused, more product review than artistic critique, you know, and I'm not ashamed of that. I don't feel there's anything wrong with that. I don't feel there's anything wrong with the artistic critique either. Okay, I guess we set the robots to work. Yeah, look at that, it's cutting it up. Okay, we're going to head into the Upside Down. It's a reference to Stranger Things, which I finished watching last night. I was very impressed. Very nice show. Great use of music. Shark. Cool. Yeah. But anyway, as I was saying, to finish a thought, I end up... I get more sidetracked than Ross Noble sometimes. The difference being that Ross Noble's funny when he does it. I'm a fan of Ross Noble. He does some good comedy shows. Anyway, the point, to get back to it, is that I don't often... I like to talk about game design when I feel like I have something to say about it. You know, we talked about that on the Jimquisition this past week. We talked about survival elements and how I feel... survival elements could be improved and how they're being misused. So I do enjoy talking about it when I feel like I've got something to say. But of course, when I talk about it on the Jimquisition, I spend time thinking about it. I'm scripting stuff out. So I when I do it off the cuff like this, just want to have a look at the, can't really do much with the outside, which is fine. You know, I don't need land. Just wondering if we could have another, just a proper little look around there, because it looks all bright and colourful. Look at these, what are they, eels? We're looking at eels. Can I do anything with them? Beep, 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 beep. Nah. So yeah, to get right back to what I was saying 20,000 minutes ago, I hope what I said about exploration games and the difference between this and some of the more mediocre ones makes sense. Because when I talk off the cuff, there is always a 50-50 chance that I'm talking a complete bollocks. But let's go tinkle with this shell anyway. Now I know why people were all a flutter about this game this morning on Twitter. Beep, 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 beep. Are they talking? Huh! Cool. Okay, pressing forward. Starfish! Starfish and sea stars doing their shit. And sea anemones having fun in the water, mate. Man, that's pretty. I need to do a review of this one, I think. Maybe get it done tomorrow. I'm assuming, like the other games, that these folks, or again, it might just be a folk. I'll have to look that up. I'm assuming, like Journey and Flower, that it's not a particularly lengthy experience. Which I do not say as an insult. I find it perfectly acceptable for a game to be quote-unquote brief. Sometimes that's the perfect length, you know, a couple of hours, as opposed to 8 hours or 40 hours, as is the classic RPG length. I wonder if there's ever been an RPG that's actually 40 hours. I don't know why I had that thought. This again is definitely a case study in how having high-end top-notch graphics do not necessarily translate into a pretty game. Certainly can. Many do. And many less graphically advanced games can be fuck ugly. But this, despite very simple character models, very angular character models as well, and very basic colours, you know, no great texture or anything, is still, just by virtue of its style, its artistic flair, and the use of colour, is still very, very pretty in its own right. It's very nice. Ourselves some manta rays there. I think they're manta rays. I used to know all about fish and shit when I was a kid. I was always a big fan of aquariums. I was enamoured with them in London Zoo. When I used to go to London Zoo on my summer holidays. Been tempted by the idea to revisit London Zoo. When I bet, can I ride one? Oh, do say I can. Come on, let's get close. Give me the good stuff. Give me a bit of juicy juice. Get it. Get it. Get it. Get it. Come on. Use a boost. No, no boost. Come on. I don't think we can ride that. Maybe I'm not close enough. I don't want to let go of the dream. Surely I can ride more than a Goliath grouper. Fast little fuckers. Come here. Nah. If you can, I've certainly not made it happen. So if we're swimming here, what's down in there? Well, nothing, we just get pushed back out. Out of the Underdark, where the water drow live. Got ourselves some ancient temples and shit. Flooded business. Is there another meditation spot so we can learn about fish? Let's get to the top of this coral. What you got for me up here? Anything at all? Oh, no. Proper Echo the Dolphin. Oh. I didn't proper Echo the Dolphin. Oh, well, fuck it. Nice music as well. There we go. There's our spot. Whee! Get over here. Alright. Got ourselves a unicorn fish. See that? Not being in a school of other fish. That's quite... Oh my god, it got 8! Got an achievement for that. Holy fuck. Look at that hungry bastard. Rooster fish. Needed the achievement to get out of the way so I could read what it was. Greedy guts. Loving it. Okay, well, that was exciting, wasn't it? Where are we at? More unicorn fish. Oh, God, it's very hard to control this. I feel like it's like magnetized to fish. Like it really wanted me to see these giant trevally here. I was trying to steer it as best I could towards the... Like, I'm trying to use the right stick to... There we are. Pull up there. Kind of fighting me a little. It's very... I don't like it. It's making me uncomfortable. Yeah. It's like locking on and zooming into certain fish. Which I'm... It's not giving me a really much of a manual control. I'm going to get out of there. Didn't like the way that felt. It's not bad if you're just like not pressing it at all and just watching the fish. But when you... If you're trying to steer it around... You've got some limited control, but it feels like it's constantly pulling and pushing you where it wants you to go. Which, I know, it doesn't feel nice. Which is the only thing so far that hasn't felt nice. In an otherwise, I'll use the word again, an otherwise very pleasant game. Okay, through these little caves. Jellyfish! Love jellyfish. Because they're fucking weird. So that's what I care about the ocean for. Weird shit. Look at that. Very mesmerizing game. Got ourselves some paintings and whatnot on the wall here. I don't know if there is a story or anything to this, so... You know, maybe we're seeing story clues down there. Can't get down there, let's... Get down. There we go. Bunch of sea people carrying sea stuff and also pots. Fun. Let us move forward. Things have certainly gotten darker and more grim here. But it looks like we're about to move back into some lively territory. Whoa! Naughty shark broke a robot! No, we've still got one left. Naughty shark broker robot. Aliens! We found a spaceship, everyone. See what the business here is. Okay. Well, that robot's fucked off. Well, I don't know if there's any other stuff in here, but hell, we'll just go where the robot went. Section 1, I guess. Presumably not the end of the game. Somewhat of a lengthy loading time. Not the lengthiest I've ever seen. Well, I don't know that yet. We could be talking about this 10 minutes from now. Who knows? Just looking in a little tiny rotating triangle. I wonder what is the smallest rotating triangle that's ever been in a video game. Could have been that one. If you've seen smaller, let us know. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Ooh. Okay. See what else we got going here. Looks like that's gonna push us. Yep. Yep, speedy time. This is the kind of stuff I liked in Journey. Whoa, right through the fish. Love the colours there, all the... Oh, let's hit this one. Yes. Love all the blues and the purples and the reds. Oh, this is nice. But yeah, there were those moments in Journey where you were sliding down sand dunes and things. This was a moment of triumph amidst all the slower exploration. And again, it's part of what made it work and made it feel so much more dynamic and interesting than just some game where you're slowly wandering around looking for things. These more rousing moments really help break up what could be a very monotonous exploration game. And very few games that try to be like this, you know, have mastered that, or even thought to try it. They just set this one monotonous tone. When really, to make this sort of game work, you want crescendos that you're building to, you want these moments that are uplifting, because they make the downtime more worthwhile, and then the downtime in turn feeds into the faster paced moments, the more exciting moments, the more intimidating moments, to make them more effective. And this is stuff I've talked about in, I'd say, in less direct terms before, in various different videos over the years. I'm a big believer in... Oh, look at that. Fuck, that's nice looking. And there we are. From that into downtime, which we appreciate more, because we just had a nice, exciting moment. And then we get to look at all the dolphin shit. I don't think those are those dolphins? Porpoises? I don't know my sea mammals too well. What can I ride, though? That's the important question. Can I ride this big thing? I need to get a better handle on these controls. I'm a little overzealous with the stick, which means I keep looping the character round. First of all, can we ride this porpoise thing? Oh god, come on. You're not doing me any favours, are ya? No. Don't know if I can. I mean, you can't just tease me with a Goliath grouper. There is that thing. Looks a little slower. And looks a little bigger. Got this big green and purple thing. Come here, you. You Ribena bastard. Can't catch anything. I'm hitting X near it and just not grabbing anything. Oh, now that's new. Press the B button. Anyway, there's another shell here. And we can see a cave down there. Presumably. A new thing to look at. Yay! Robot! Well, anyway, I'm gonna give it a rest there. I'm sure I can catch some of these things. Now again, pressing the ride button and stuff near it, but just not managing it. Do love how everything reacts as you get near it. Things closing up here. Another little place to meditate. Common dolphin. There we go. I guess because when I think dolphin, I think the very stereotypical flipper, grey fella. Not this, the black and white looking creature. And that's a coral trout. And a humphead wrasse. Look at that. You can see its hump head. Poor bastard. Yeah, my mistake was trying to, like, manually control the stuff earlier. If you just flick the stick, it will move you to the next fish. That's what I should have been doing. And that way we get to look at a bicolor parrotfish. There's another coral trout there. More parrotfish. So yeah, all the fun of the fish. There's an azure damselfish. How about that? And who could forget the bannerfish? And the other bannerfish. So that's ABZÛ anyways. As we end on a Lyretail Antheus. Very, very laid back game. Very calming game. Very enjoyable game. I like it. And I'm learning about fish, which is nice. Learning a lot more about fish than I did about that Zen Fish Simulator. Remember that one? Gee, maybe I will subtitle this one Zen Fish Simulator. Because it is everything that game, I guess, in its wildest, most ambitious dreams wanted to be. Because this simulates fish and is very Zen. So there we are, ABZÛ. The brain behind Journey gave us a Zen Fish Sim. How nice. How nice indeed. Alright, I'm gonna go and feel nice and calm for the rest of the day. And I advise you all to do the same. Goodbye.